So I'm gonna do the finishing touches now, and one of the things I need to pay attention to is to make this eye brighter. It's more yellow. I think this one's okay. There's probably a bit more of a mustardy colour on the edge there, but we'll do this eye because I've got this, got the focus on this eye, so you should be able to see. So we're going to kind of put a bit more. See, that's mustardy. I think we've got to try and go those kind of colours. Yeah, that's the mustardy colour. This is the yellow. So it's gonna be a bit more of a lighter yellow, I think, because we've got plenty of green over here. So we'll try and. I've sharpened up my pencil. This is quite light here. There's a little notch there. Lighter. Just there. Mustardy in there. This is a little bit more streaky through here, and that could be a little bit lighter there. Just really hardly touching this, very, very light touches. Quite dark. I'm not going to go up there. Quite light on the edge. Then it's going right down there. This is a bit more mustardy here, but I'm going to put this in first because it's, I suppose it is a bit of a dark colour. We'll have to repair that black line there. We'll do that again. Lightened it up a bit. Now we've just got to try and put some more colour in here, make it more golden, really. more skull here. Very, very light touch. Yeah, I think that's a bit better. We'll need to put some green in. My black. Do this now. It's a really thin line there. We need to make that a bit thinner. A bit of pink in there. Just getting on while I see it here. Just a little bit. There. But it's darker, so I'm going to put the blue over it. It's got a bit more green in here now. So we're going to use this 168 in here now. Very slightly, just glazing over this golden colour. Make it a bit more greeny here. here. This is too low. Very thin. Going to cover that up, I think, because that could have been not great. Carried away with the eye there. That's what happens. Get carried away and don't concentrate on what I'm leaving on. Now, let's just stand back a bit here and have a look at this. Is so sharp. I have a nice light bit there. Okay, so just to brighten it all up a bit, I'm going to just blend it with this very light yellow, very, very lightly, rather than use a colour shaper. And then we'll take another look at that tomorrow. I'll put some more white in there. I would like this thinner, this bit here. That's right there. This light bit, it's not going right up to the line, there's a slight greyness there under his black bit there. water. I'm going to take this sort of mark up here a bit. It's a bit low. It's not looking quite right. Making his pupil look funny. I need to point on this white pencil. There's a tiny little white fleck there, and it's just above that bit there. A bit on the high side now. Let me have a look at that. It's quite a bit higher. Right on there. Rusty bit there. And it needs a bit of grey over it because it's not that bright. And that white neck is actually a bit low. This is too low. That's what's wrong. Everything's in the wrong place. dabbing it in really pushes in the pastel without taking too much off it. We can put some more on if we need to. Spots of colour in now. Then we'll press it all in, finally with the glassine paper. More mustard, I think, in here. Light bit just here. That's it. Okay. Okay, we'll just see how that looks tomorrow, I think. That grey we need for that. The line going through the right there, we'll put that back. It's going right through it. There. And then up here. And over the top of that. So, yeah, to seal that all in, I would use this paper now. And use the glassine. Just give it a little press. Pushes it all in. needs more doing to it, really. Just having to really use the colour that we've got here, really. Trying to bring it to life with what we've got here. Okay, I'll leave the eye now. So one of the other things was it needed to be lighter. See, I've broken off this stick here. This is the Schmink stick that we've used on his white bit there. But it needs to be kind of lifting this bit here. Not dead white, but when we blend it in a bit with the other colours there, it'll be better. Do the colour shaper on that now. Make sure it's nice and clean. Look a bit grubby actually. Again, what we're going to do with that is we'll press it in. To be a little bit lighter around this area here. See, mine's quite dark in comparison, so we'll just go over it with a white, very sharp point. These hairs here are going in another direction, they're almost spots really. Just pop those in. And yeah, they're going across that way, and then they're coming down this way. We've got to try to leave some of the background, but lift the area. And it's dark. There's a darker little patch under there. I've left it too dark, really. So, yes, there it is. We need to could even put a bit of yellow on this and make it more creamy. But as long as it's lifted, I'd lost that line here. See? By bringing it back makes a big difference. So this is thanks to John, my husband, noticing this. When you're working on something, you get so close to it, you're just concentrating on the bit that you're doing, and you miss all these extra things. Now this is darker here, but it isn't that dark. So that's much better. That needs to go a bit bluer. This is white, much whiter here. Just try not to lean on that. It's not standing out much more, isn't it? tastes a bit lighter, yeah. Just going to soften that all a bit with the colour shaper, give it a wipe off. Got a paper towel down here.